Hello everyone, very good evening to all of you and welcome to the Unacademy YouTube session. So today, myself, Dr. Devesh Mishra, and I am a pathology faculty at Unacademy, and I am a, you know, author of the best selling book called Concepts in Pathology. You might be reading about this book also, right? So today I'm going to discuss about a very important topic, that is the tumor marker, right? Because in every exam, you will be finding some question from here. So let's begin with the tumor marker. So before I start, some important thing which I want to tell you, that this plus subscription, which is available at Unacademy, where you can see daily live classes, structured courses, live tests and quizzes, and unlimited access you can see here, right? There is a combination of the Unacademy plus prep ladder. These are the, you know, courses, live courses. This is the recorded lecture. So you can subscribe both of them. So this is called iconic subscription. So if you are using my name as a code, Dr. Devesh 10, so you will be getting 10% of the discount also, right? And this is the limited time offer that Unacademy, if you're buying for 3 months, you will be having, these are the, you know, various pricing you can see, which has been earlier very high, now it has been reduced. So you can join here also, you can use the icon 10 as a subscription also, right? So this is the another important thing which I was telling you, 3 months if you are subscribing, you will be getting 1 month free. These are the foundation batches which you can join. It started from the 19th of the May. This is the MBBS foundation batch for the third year, so it is again starting today only, right? So you can join here. These are the FMG and test analysis batch, and target next batch you can join, which has been started on 17th of the May. This is the NEET PG21 image based revision batch, 19th May. It has been started, you can see also this one also. And there are so many questions which are being created at Unacademy, so you can see here also, and you can practice also. There are 34,000 questions you can practice, and you can, you know, by practicing you can master how to, you know, appear in exam and how to attempt all these MCQs. So these are the various subscription rate you can see, that after the lecture you can see these all things will be present in the PDF also. So these are the subscription various things, right? So if it is iconic subscription, this is the plus and iconic subscription, right? So now you can see all these prices, and you can use the code, as I have told you, my name as a code, you will be getting discount for that thing. So let's start in this tumor marker. What I want to tell, first, I will give you some questions also, right? There will be some MCQs, for the simple MCQs, not very high-fi questions, right? And we will be going through how we have to approach for a patient. Basically, a cancer patient or a tumor patient is coming to us. Basic thing is to understand how to approach when a patient is coming. So you know that when first you are going to have a clinical examination. After the clinical examination, you are going for minimally invasive, you know, analysis like CBC, FNAC, all these things, right? Then you will be going for the biopsies. So when you are going for CBC or taking out the blood, that moment you are going to take out the tumor markers, right? So tumor markers, what we have to understand, tumor markers are the biochemical compounds, right, which are present in our body. And when a tumor patient is approaching us, you are going to take out the blood sample, and then you are going to analyze the marker into the blood sample, right? So that is the tumor marker. So basically tumor marker is used to identify that what kind of tumor it can be. Try to understand what kind of tumor it can be, not for the confirmation, just to identify what it can be. So you can say that simply it is used for screening, right? So let's have one question in front of you, right? Tumor markers are found in, and just remember this question, you give me the answer. Yes, very good, Neelam. Very good evening, Neelam, Nitesh, Tanvi, Yo-Yo. So I want to give me the right answer. These are having multiple answers. So multiple answers, right? So what should be right answer? Tumor markers are found in, where you are going to see the tumor marker, in blood or in urine or in blood tissue or in any other body tissue. Anybody? Yes, very good, very nice. Neelam, Tanvi, Vedansh, Srishti, Akash, very good. Subhasmita, very good, very nice. All of the above, Sumi, very nice. Everybody has said me the right answer. So remember what I said, tumor markers are the normal biochemical substances, right? which can be present in blood also, which can be present in urine also, and it can be present in various tissues also, right? Like a testicular tissue, urinary bladder tissue, right? So please remember, blood is also a connective tissue, right? So that's the point which I wanted to say, that it can be present in all of them, right? So answer is D. Very nice. So very good. Fantastic. Everybody has given me the right answer. Very happy for this. So let's see. As I was telling you, tumor marker. Kya hai tumor marker? Tumor markers are the normal substances, right? Normal substances, and where they are found? They are found in blood. They are found in urine. They will be seen in the body tissue, right? So normal substances, they will be present normally also, right? They will be present normally also. But during the tumor formation, their level will be increased. So they will be increased in tumor, right? So now you understand, what is the tumor marker? They are present in the blood, they are present in the urine, they are present in the body tissue, all where, all type of fluid tissue they can be present, and they are normal, actually normal biochemical substances, and they can be increased in the tumor. That is the basis of the tumor marker, right? Now coming to the next question, this is again a multiple answer type of question. Read this question very carefully. I will give you half minute and tell me the right answer in the comment box. I'm waiting for this. True about tumor marker is R. To confirm the diagnosis, for screening of the tumors, to correlate growth or size of the tumor, or therapeutic response assessment. Now you tell me, multiple answer. This question is like INICT type, right? Okay, B, D, okay, B, D, okay, screening of tumor, okay, B, C, D, very nice. Aman Agrawal is the first one to tell me the right answer. Aman Agrawal and Nitesh both are simultaneously giving the right answer. Very good, very nice. Aman Agrawal and Nitesh has given me right answer. See, many of you have given right answer, but that is not the complete right answer. See, right answer is, it is for screening of the tumor also, number one. Right, it's for correlation of the size of the tumor also, and therapeutic response assessment also. So there are three answers. So please remember, what is the right answer for this question? B, C, and D. So this is the correct answer. So please remember, this is the correct answer for this question. Right. Now let's have a discussion. When a patient is coming to us, you remember what I said, you are going to take out the blood and you are going to identify which kind of tumor it can be. Right? Which kind of tumor it can be. It cannot be confirming the diagnosis, because these are the normal biochemical substances. You remember what I said? Tumor markers are the normal biochemical substances which may be increased during tumor. You don't understand? Normal may be increased during tumor. So that is why their sensitivity is high, but the specificity is not there. So it is not used for confirmation of the diagnosis. So remember, not for confirmation of the diagnosis, right? So what is the purpose? First, you will screen the tumor. So like a breast cancer, ovarian tumor, you are going to see, carbohydrate antigen or glycoprotein. So that is for the screening of the tumor, right? Now the C point, this point was the question in the PGI exam also, to correlate growth or size of the tumor. So here I would like to give you example of the choriocarcinoma. So when seeing a choriocarcinoma patient, right, that time you are going to check their marker, that is the beta HCG marker, right? So when you are going to see the growth of this tumor, right, when choriocarcinoma growth, which you can measure in the terms of size also, right? So size or growth, if they are increasing, right, if size and growth of choriocarcinoma is increasing, then beta HCG level will be also high. They will be also increased. So that is the point we have to remember, right? So now you understand. So that's what I wanted to say, that they can correlate growth or size of the tumor also. For example, it is a choriocarcinoma, right? So whenever you are dealing with a patient of the choriocarcinoma, if size is more, then blood will be showing you more beta-HCG, right? Now, coming to the D option, therapeutic response to the right therapeutic response to the treatment when you are going to check. For example, if you take example of the colon cancer, right? You are a surgeon and you have resected colon cancer, and now you want to follow up the patient. So what you are going to do in follow-up process, you are going to check the carcinoembryonic antigen, right? So carcinoembryonic antigen, you are going to do the follow-up, right? So what will happen? Carcinoembryonic antigen will start decreasing after some time, right? If the treatment has been done or patient is responding properly, so carcinoembryonic antigen will be start decreasing, right? They will be start decreasing in the blood, right? So that is the therapeutic response, right? In case when you are observing the patient, right, of the colon cancer after the surgery, right, after the surgery, and you are noticing that after 3 months there is a again increase in carcinoembryonic antigen. Now you are seeing another tumor marker, carcinoembryonic antigen, another aspect I am showing you. One, you have seen therapeutic assessment. Therapeutically, he is responding because carcinoembryonic antigen is decreasing. But now we have a case where carcinoembryonic antigen is increasing. So what is the meaning of this thing? If you are a surgeon and you have done a colorectal surgery some 6 months back, and now patient has come to you, carcinoembryonic antigen is increasing. So what is the meaning of that thing? Is it normal or is it showing recurrence? Anybody in the comment box? Is it normal or is it showing you recurrence? Yes. Yes, please tell me. Very nice. Very good. Rahul Saxena has told me the first. It is a marker of recurrence also. So what I can say that tumor marker can be used for assessment of the therapeutic response as well as to check the recurrences also, right? So not for confirmation of the diagnosis. So now what is the takeaway message from this question? Tumor marker is not to confirm the diagnosis. They are used for screening of the tumor. They can correlate growth and size of the tumor. You can check the therapeutic response, and you can also assess for the recurrence of the tumor after the treatment. Right? Very nice. So many of you have told me, Neelam, Aman, Amit, Mishi, Tanvi, everybody has told me, very good. Recurrence. So recurrence is also assessed by the tumor marker. Right? So now seeing this question, now you can see that what I have told you, tumor markers are not used for confirmation of diagnosis. So now you understand, we will never try to confirm the diagnosis by tumor marker. Why? Because tumor markers are normal biochemical substances, right? So remember, they are normal biochemical substances. That is why it is not used for confirmation. So this is the reason. Normal biochemical substances, right? So you can confuse with the normalcy also. So that is why we should not use them to confirm. But yes, it is for correlation, or it is for the corroboration, right? Or for the screening, for the recurrence, or for the therapeutic responses, right? Now, as I have told you, so what should be the purpose? Screening, therapeutic response, as I have told you, recurrences, and growth or size of the tumor. You remember? Choriocarcinoma growth will be more, beta-HCG will be more, right? Colon cancer, I have given you for the therapeutic response. If colon cancer resection is, giving proper response, there will be decrease in carcinoembryonic antigen, right? Screening of the tumor, various tumor, breast cancer, ovarian tumor, many glycoproteins, right? So they are used for the tumor marker for screening of the tumor, right? So let's have another question. Now in front of your screen, tell me right answer, multiple answer type. Tumor markers is are, what are the tumor markers? Tell me. They are hormones or oncofetal antigen or enzymes or glycoprotein. What should be the correct answer? Multiple answer type. Now I'm waiting for it. Right. Very nice. Very nice. I want to. Yes. Very good. Very nice. Very nice. Saransh Acharya. Remember this name. Then Subhasmita. Very nice. Very good. Very good. So I'm very happy that nearly all of you have given me the perfect and correct answer. This is how question is going to be asked in your next exam or INICT exam. See, these are all tumor markers, all are right answers. So for this question, remember, for this question, correct answer is all. A, B, C, D, all are correct. A, B, C, D, all are correct answer. Right? All are correct answer. A, B, C, D, all are correct. They are hormones also. They can be oncofetal antigen also. They can be enzyme also. They can be glycoprotein. I will be, not glycoprotein. Who said? Pankaj, no. Glycoproteins are also carcinoembryonic antigen. Carbohydrate antigen, CA15. All these are the glycoprotein only, right? So please remember this thing. They're all tumor markers, right? So here, I would like to tell you, see, this is how we classify tumor markers. So that question was from the classification. So what are the tumor markers? It can be hormones also. It can be oncofetal antigen also. It can be enzymes also. It can be tumor associated glycoprotein also. It can be CD marker. And there are some interesting other markers also, which I wanted to tell you, which examiner can ask you in your exam, which are the recent updates, right? So now you understand. They can be hormone, they can be oncofetal protein, they can be enzyme, tumor associated glycoprotein, CD marker, and many other things, right? So let's have another question. This question is again correct. You have to correct the match. Which match is correct? Now you have to find out. And there are multiple answers which can be correct here, right? So now listen to this. I'm going to repeat. I'm going to give you 1 minute time. Vanillyl mandelic acid for pheochromocytoma. 5-hydroxyindole acetic acid for carcinoid. Calcitonin for papillary carcinoma of thyroid. And alpha HCG for choriocarcinoma. So these are the four options. So tell me, what are the correct answer here? Okay, who is telling? Yes, MD medicine. Who is this MD medicine? Now, Yuvraj, MD medicine. Okay. D. Okay. Very nice. See, A, B, D. A, B, D. Many of you are telling. So let me tell you what should be the right answer. A, B, C, D, अरे बाप रे, A, B, C, D नहीं है, सुनो मेरा बात, now you listen to me very carefully, because you are getting trapped into the language, you are getting biased by seeing the, you know, tumor marker, calcitonin का मतलब thyroid, HCG का मतलब choriocarcinoma, ऐसा नहीं है, it is not like that, see this, I'll just tell you, right answer is, A, and B only. Vanillyl mandelic acid is for pheochromocytoma. That is the true answer. 5-hydroxyindole acetic acid is for carcinoid. That is also correct answer. 5-hydroxyindole acetic acid, I'll just tell you, just for fraction of second I want to take. There is a pleasant memory of this 5-HIAA and carcinoid. This was the question when I was writing my, you know, first year exam, biochemistry. My madam had asked me, if you tell me 5-HIAA is a tumor marker of which tumor, I will give you pass. And you know, that morning itself, one of my final year senior has told me, "Arey, carcinoid is very common. 5-HIAA puch sakte wo log na." But that time, you know, first year mein itna puchte nahi the. But that madam has asked me, and you know, I was performing very poorly in that exam because of this question only. She gave me pass. Right. So I'm very thankful. So I remember this, and I think you will also remember this. This was the NEET PG question in 2018, right? So now I understand. Now you tell me, those who are telling calcitonin, for them, calcitonin, you tell me, calcitonin is for papillary or some other cancer? Very good. Kaushik is telling, very nice. Kaushik is telling that it is not papillary carcinoma of thyroid. This should be medullary carcinoma of the thyroid. So please remember this point. If examiner is asking you this question, you have to be very careful. What examiner is asking, you have to understand. So this is for medullary carcinoma of thyroid, right? So this is the medullary carcinoma, not the papillary cancer, right? So for medullary carcinoma. Now, those who have said D. What is alpha-HCG? Alpha-HCG is not a tumor marker for choriocarcinoma. What is tumor marker for choriocarcinoma? You remember, just now when I was telling you the growth and size. Yes, beta-HCG, very nice. So it is beta-HCG, very good. Beta-HCG is the tumor marker. This is the old MCQ in the NEET and AIIMS exam. Alpha HCG is not a tumor marker. Please remember, it's a not a tumor marker. It's a reason. It's not a tumor marker, right? Alpha HCG is not a tumor marker. Why? So what should be the assertion? What should be the correct assertion for this question? Reason is not a tumor marker. What will be the assertion for this thing? Sorry, assertion is this one. Sorry. This is the assertion. What will be the reason for this one? Reason. Assertion is alpha HCG is not a tumor marker. Yes, very good. They are similar to which hormone? Alpha subunit. Remember this point. Alpha subunit is similar to the LH, FSH, three hormones, LH, FSH, and TSH. So that is why it is not a tumor marker. So now you understand. Examiner will be telling you assertion is alpha HCG is not a tumor marker, and reason will be they are resembling to the LH, FSH, and TSH alpha subunit of the beta HCG. Now I understand. Vanillin mandelic acid is for pheochromocytoma. This was also neat question in 2018, right? So now you understand this point, right? So moving on to the next one. Now you can see this is what I wanted to tell. The tumor markers are hormones also. You remember what I have told you, the first thing. Tumor markers can be hormone also. So what hormones? Calcitonin. Calcitonin for medullary carcinoma of thyroid. Beta HCG. Now you understand? Beta. Please remember it is beta. Beta HCG is for choriocarcinoma and 15% of seminoma. Remember, 15% of seminoma will arise from plastic tissue, and that is why even for seminoma it can be a tumor marker. That was the question in exam, right? So it is for seminoma also, right? Now 5-HIAA, as I have told you, that my favorite question, right? So this is the 5-hydroxyindole acid for carcinoid. Vanillin mandelic acid is for two important tumors, remember, neuroblastoma and pheochromocytoma, right? So now you understand. All these are hormones. So hormones are also tumor marker. Calcitonin, beta HCG, 5-hydroxyindole acetic acid, vanillin mandelic acid. So these are example of hormones which can be a tumor marker, right? Let's see another question. Serum alpha fetoprotein level is raised in. So what should be right answer? Serum alpha fetoprotein, multiple answer type, embryonal carcinoma, seminoma, endodermal sinus tumor, hepatocellular cancer, fibrolamellar variant. So what should be the right answer? I want to see how many of you are giving me right answer for this question. Serum alpha fetoprotein level is raised in or a tumor marker. Okay. A, C, D, बापरे, A and D. Nobody is telling me the correct answer. Please tell me the correct. Yes, Dr. Shushrut J. Sangpal. Very good. Dr. Shushrut J. Sangpal has given me the first correct answer. That is A and C. Please. What I want to tell you that try to remember. Language is very important in exam. You cannot ignore the language of the questions and language of the options. See, many of you are telling hepatocellular carcinoma. Can you see what is this written here? Fibrolamellar variant. Fibrolamellar variant is a variant of hepatocellular carcinoma where alpha fetoprotein level will be normal. So you understand? So this is ruled out. Fine. What is endodermal sinus tumor, also known as yolk sac tumor? Yolk sac tumor. What is yolk sac tumor? Anybody? Can you tell me what is yolk sac tumor? It's a seminoma or non-seminoma? Non-seminomatous condition, right? So it is a non-seminomatous condition. So in non-seminomatous condition, you will see alpha fetoprotein level will be high. And please remember, in amongst all the non-seminomatous condition, alpha fetoprotein level will be maximally increased. So there will be maximum increase in alpha fetoprotein level in case of yolk sac tumor or endodermal sinus tumor. So this is the correct answer. C is correct answer. Seminoma alpha fetoprotein is not a tumor marker, right? So this is not a right answer. Embryonal carcinoma is again a non-seminomatous condition. Please, please, please. Again, it is a non-seminomatous condition, and here will be also there will be increase in the alpha fetoprotein level. So there are two answers. So what are the answers? A and C. This is the correct answer. Everybody, now you understand? So this is a very, very important thing. Serum alpha fetoprotein level is raised in embryonal carcinoma and endodermal sinus tumor, which is also known as yolk sac tumor. And what are these things? These are the non-seminomatous condition. Right? So these are the non-seminomatous condition. So please be clear about this. Seminoma, hepatocellular cancer. In hepatocellular cancer, alpha fetoprotein is elevated, but only for the fibrolamellar variant, it is not elevated. So what is the tumor marker for fibrolamellar variant of hepatocellular carcinoma? Anybody? Can you tell me what is the tumor marker? Can you tell me what is the tumor marker for fibrolamellar variant of the hepatocellular carcinoma? Anybody? In the comment box. Hepatocellular carcinoma, usually they have alpha fetoprotein level increased, but a special variant called as fibrolamellar variant will be having normal alpha fetoprotein level, and fibrolamellar will be having a very good prognosis, and their tumor marker is neurotensin, right? So their tumor marker is neurotensin. Right, so neurotensin tumor marker. Please remember neurotensin. Yes, very nice, very nice. Sajat, Siddharth, right? Very good, very nice, very nice. MD medicine, all are very good, right? So just keep attempting all these MCQ. Don't worry, even if you're giving me wrong answer, see, nobody is going to catch up you, right? I'm not going to ask you why you are giving me wrong answer, right? It's not like that. Try. And once you commit mistake, don't worry, you are going to not commit that, or you're not going to repeat that mistake again in your exam. So do the mistake here in this discussion, in this class, but not here onwards, right? So that's the great thing which I have got from your response. So now you understand. So let us see. As I have told you, tumor marker can be hormones, can be oncofetal antigen. So now we are seeing the second type of tumor marker, that is the oncofetal antigen. So this is the oncofetal antigen. So what are the two important oncofetal antigens? CEA, carcino embryonic antigen, and second is alpha fetoprotein, right? So there are two important oncofetal antigen. Carcinoembryonic antigen is used for colon, pancreas, and breast cancer. So this was question in NEET exam also. Carcinoembryonic antigen is a tumor marker for the breast cancer. So please remember. See, colon and pancreas is again a very often asked question in exam. But breast, very few people were knowing that even the breast cancer will be having carcinoembryonic antigen, right? Right. So carcinoembryonic antigen can be also a tumor marker for the breast cancer. Now, alpha fetoprotein is a tumor marker. Aditya Vasisth. You can see this video again, right? It will be available, right? This live session will be available at an academy's YouTube section. You can see this, right? So alpha fetoprotein, when you are going to see, they are marker of the hepatocellular carcinoma also and hepatoblastoma also. This was the question in NEET PG exam 2014. That time this question was very deadly, because see, both are having alpha fetoprotein, but examiner had asked, tell me single right answer, because that time single correct answer will you have to choose. So what is the single correct answer you have to choose here? See, this single correct answer, when you have to choose, you should remember that hepatocellular carcinoma, you will be having alpha fetoprotein in 70% of the cases, whereas hepatoblastoma, more than 90% of the cases will be positive for the fetoprotein. So that is why, if you have to choose single better answer should be hepatoblastoma, right? Again, non-seminomatous germ cell tumor. Already I have told you, embryonal carcinoma of the testis, yolk sac tumor of the testis, teratoma, right? Choriocarcinoma, all these non-seminomatous conditions will be having increased level of alpha fetoprotein, right? And whenever alpha fetoprotein, see, examiner also asks this kind of question. Maximum level of alpha fetoprotein will be seen in which tumor? Which non-seminomatous condition? So remember, yolk sac tumor will be having maximum increase in alpha fetoprotein level. Already I have told you this thing, right? So now you understand, hormones, oncofetal antigen, like as carcinoembryonic antigen, alpha fetoprotein, these are all examples of the tumor markers. Now, come to the next question. Again, multiple answer type. Let us see who gives me the first answer. सबसे पहले कौन सही करेक्ट आंसर बताता है? करेक्ट आंसर, आई एम टॉकिंग अबाउट करेक्ट आंसर. नो इश्यू, इग्नोर दैट मुजाम, दैट इज डिफरेंट बिजनेस, राइट? सो विच ऑफ द फॉलोइंग इज करेक्ट मैच? मल्टीपल आंसर टाइप. न्यूरॉन स्पेसिफिक एनोलेज, राइट, फॉर स्मॉल सेल कैंसर ऑफ द लंग. अल्फा वन एंटीट्रिप्सिन इज फॉर एंडोडर्मल साइनस ट्यूमर. एलडीएच इज फॉर सेमिनोमा. प्रोमोग्रेनिन इज फॉर न्यूरोब्लास्टोमा. सो विच इज द करेक्ट मैच? टेल मी विच वन इज द करेक्ट मैच. थैंक यू सो मच मुझा. ओके, आई वॉन्ट टू सी द करेक्ट आंसर. हु इज गिविंग मी द फर्स्ट करेक्ट आंसर? ए सी डी. यू आर रीचिंग अप टू दैट. ओके, ए सी. ओके, शिवांग, आई एम फ्रॉम के एम सी चेन्नई, किलपॉक मेडिकल कॉलेज चेन्नई. माई एम डी इज फ्रॉम नायर हॉस्पिटल, टी एन एम सी मुंबई. ए बी सी डी, वेरी गुड. क्या नाम है? कलाकोंडा मेघना. मेघना हैज गिवन मी द फर्स्ट आंसर. ए बी सी डी ऑल आर करेक्ट आंसर. न्यूरॉन स्पेसिफिक एनोलेज इज अ ट्यूमर मार्कर फॉर न्यूरो एंडोक्राइन ट्यूमर. सो स्मॉल सेल कैंसर इज ऑल्सो अ न्यूरो एंडोक्राइन ट्यूमर, राइट? एल्फा वन एंटी ट्रिप्सिन इज ऑल्सो अ ट्यूमर मार्कर फॉर एंडोडर्मल साइनस ट्यूमर, विच इज ऑल्सो कॉल्ड एज योक सैक ट्यूमर ऑफ द टेस्टिस. यू रिमेंबर? सो नाउ यू अंडरस्टैंड, दीज योक सैक ट्यूमर्स और एंडोडर्मल साइनस ट्यूमर, यू बी हैविंग टू मार्कर्स, एल्फा फीटोप्रोटीन एंड एल्फा वन एंटीट्रिप्सिन. सो दीज आर द टू ट्यूमर मार्कर्स यू हैव टू रिमेंबर फॉर एंडोडर्मल साइनस ट्यूमर और योक सैक ट्यूमर, करेक्ट? नाउ LDH is one of the very important tumor marker for seminoma, so this is also correct. Prostaglandin is also a tumor marker for neuroendocrine tumor like a neuroblastoma, right? So now you understand, prostaglandin is also a tumor marker for neuroendocrine tumor, small cell cancer, neuroblastoma, paraganglioma, right? So now you understand this thing. So all these are the markers. All ABCD is correct. So those who have given ABCD correct answer, I think Meghna has given me the only correct answer till now, right? But no issue, don't worry. Those who have given me A, C, A, B, A, D, whatever, A, C, D, they are also right. So only thing is, you are not getting total full marks, but you are also right. So that's great response, right? So that's great response. So let's see, what are the enzymes? These are all enzymes. What I have shown you, they are all enzymes. So that's what I wanted to say that. Now you understand, hormones. Then we have seen oncofetal antigen. Then now we are seeing enzymes. They are also tumor markers. So what are these enzymes? Neuron specific enolase, alpha 1 antitrypsin, and LDH. These are three important enzymes which are the tumor marker. Neuron specific enolase, as I have told you, neuron specific enolase and chromogranin, they are the tumor marker for neuroendocrine tumor. And remember, all these are neuroendocrine tumor, neuroblastoma, small cell cancer, pheochromocytoma, right? So that is why neuron specific enolase and chromogranin both are tumor marker for the neuroendocrine tumor. Now you understand. And all neuroendocrine, carcinoid, neuroblastoma, small cell cancer, pheochromocytoma, all will be, you know. Okay, so all will be a tumor marker. Alpha 1 antitrypsin is a yolk sac tumor marker, as I have told you, right? Yolk sac tumor will be alpha fetoprotein, also alpha fetoprotein. LDH, you have to remember one very important thing, because when you will be working as a clinician and you are ordering liver function test, that time you may find LDH will be raised. So when you find LDH is raised, that will be also one indication for hepatocellular carcinoma. I have seen one case like that. Right, I have seen one case like that where patient was having hepatocellular carcinoma, who was known to me, and his only finding was LDH was elevated in the in his blood analysis. Otherwise, clinically he was showing the symptoms like weight loss was there. He was having jaundice and all everything. So this was also raised, and that was the big thing which I came to know that time. So please remember, LDH is for not only for the seminoma, it is for hepatocellular carcinoma also. So moving on to the next one. Now you tell me which of the following is correct match. This is again, no, this is not again. It's not multiple type. Only one answer is correct answer. So tell me, CA15-3 is for ovarian tumor, 19-9 for breast cancer, 72-4 for gastric cancer, 125 for pancreatic adenocarcinoma. Yes, LDH is more specific. LDH is more specific. D, 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 D. Everybody is D, right? CA125 is D. Somebody's telling C. That's great. That's great. Who is this? Who is this? Meghna. Then Hakimi. Very nice. Very good. Right? Anmol. Rahul. Very good. Very good. Those who are seeing C, Aman Agrawal, Amit Chaturvedi, all these are excellent. So remember, answer for this question is C. There is nothing else, right? So only C is the correct answer here. CA724 is the gastric cancer. 15-3 is for which tumor? Can you tell me? For breast cancer. Right? CA99 is for not for the breast. It is for pancreas. Right? CA125 is not for the pancreas. It is for ovarian tumor. So now you understand? This is for CA72 is for gastric cancer. So this simple question, right? I just kept this answer because many of you might not be knowing about this CA24. So this question answer is CA724, which is the tumor marker for the gastric adenocarcinoma. Now, remember when we started, what are the tumor markers? That time I told you tumor markers can be glycoprotein. You remember? So they are glycoprotein, tumor associated glycoprotein. So what are these? Carbohydrate antigen. CA stands for carbohydrate antigen. So carbohydrate antigen 15-3 is for CA breast. I understand. Breast cancer is 15-3. 19-9 is for colon, pancreas, and breast. Right? So very often asked question. 19-9, CA19-9 is for colon, pancreas, and breast. CA27-29. Remember, this was the NEET question in 2014. So this is a good question, tough question because very less often asked. So CA27-9 is for the breast cancer. 72-4, I had asked for this question and I have given you answer breast. But remember, this will be positive in the pancreas as well as ovarian tumor also, right? So now you understand gastric carcinoma, pancreatic adenocarcinoma, ovarian carcinoma, all these are. LDH we are not using for the Hodgkin's lymphoma. Why to use Hodgkin's lymphoma? Hodgkin's tumor we are not going to use. LDH may be increased, right? LDH may be increased, but not we are not using. I have not seen that thing, right? So now you can see CA125 is the ovarian tumor. So these are all glycoproteins. So glycoproteins are also tumor markers. Now come to the next question. This is again a multiple answer type, INICT type of question. CD99 is a tumor marker for which tumor? Now you tell me which tumor. I want to see that who is giving me the first correct answer. Multiple answers will be right here. CD99 is a tumor marker for which tumor? AAAD. Okay, who is this? Who is this? AD, Amit Chaturvedi. Very nice. Amit Chaturvedi has given me the first correct answer. Then Meghna is, I think simultaneously both have given me correct answer. A and D, A and D. So that is A and D. Very nice. Right? No, it is not A and C. It is A and D. CD99. CD99 is also known as MYC2, if you remember. They are also known as MYC2. And this is a tumor marker for two cancers. One is bone cancer, one is ovarian tumor. Sarcoma and granulosa cell tumor. Right? So this is the ovarian tumor, right? Ovarian tumor, granulosa cell tumor, and bone tumor, Ewing sarcoma. Both will be positive for CD99, or which is also known as MYC2. Small lymphocytic lymphoma is not positive for this. Dysgerminoma is not positive for this thing, right? So now I understand. As I told you, there are many other things which are tumor markers. So these CD markers are also tumor marker. CD25. This was a question in the All India exam. It's for hairy cell leukemia. Apart from that, CD11 and CD103 is also tumor marker for the hairy cell leukemia. CD11103 is also a tumor marker for hairy cell leukemia. CD30 is for embryonal carcinoma of the testis. That was the question in NEET 2015 and 17. Twice this question came. Remember, twice this question came. CD30 is tumor marker for which tumor of the testis? Embryonal carcinoma of the testis, that non-seminomatous condition, right? CD99 or MYC2, this was the question, right, which I had asked you. This is again an AIIMS All India question. Ewing sarcoma and granulosa cell tumor. So that was the question for right. CD10 is also known as common ALL antigen, which is present in B cell type of acute lymphoblastic leukemia, right? CD117, again a very dangerous question which examiner often ask in exam. Actually CD117 is a marker for the myeloid cell also. So this will be positive in the myeloid tumor also. Right? This will be positive in the myeloid tumor also, like CML, AML, all these things, right? What is very frequently asked in your exam, and you when you are doing your surgery posting, you might be seeing the GIST, right? Gastrointestinal stromal tumor, which is positive for CD117. So gastrointestinal stromal tumor, seminoma, melanoma, chronic myeloid leukemia, as I said, myeloid tumor, right? So these are the cancers where you will be finding CD117 as a tumor marker. So remember, it is not only GIST. It can be seminoma, it can be melanoma, it can be AML, it can be CML. So all these things are tumor markers. All these things are positive for the tumor marker of CD117, right? So these are the CD markers, right? Now we are moving on to the next question. Tumor marker for breast cancer is R, multiple answer type. So this is again INICT type of question. So tell me, what should be the right answer for this question? I want to see that. Who is giving me the first answer? A, B, D. Breast cancer. Shivank. A, B, C, D. No. A, B, C. Who is this? 1 minute. Saransh Acharya. A, B, C. He is the first one to tell me the correct answer. Aman Agrawal also told me, but he has given me the D also as an answer. So please remember, it is A, B, and C. So tumor marker for breast cancer, see, CA15 is tumor marker. Oncotype DX is also tumor marker. Carcinoembryonic antigen, as I have told you earlier, right, in the discussion, these are all tumor markers. So CA15, Oncotype DX, carcinoembryonic antigen, these are all tumor marker. PAX8 is not a tumor marker here. But here I would like to emphasize about the PAX8. PAX8 was the question in PGI 2017. And this is a tumor marker for two tumors, ovarian tumors and thyroid cancers. So please remember this point also. So ovarian tumor and thyroid cancer, both will be positive for PAX8. Thyroid cancer, especially if you ask me, papillary and follicular thyroid cancer. Right? PAX8 is actually a gene which is for development of ovary and thyroid. That's why they are considered as a tumor marker for ovarian tumor also and thyroid tumor also. So that was the question in PGI exam. So now you understand, PAX8 is a tumor marker for ovarian tumor and thyroid tumor. Ovarian tumor, thyroid tumor, papillary and follicular. So now you understand this thing. So breast cancer, Oncotype DX, carcinoembryonic antigen, CA15, all these are tumor marker for the breast cancer. So A, B, C is the correct answer. Correct answer is A, B, C. Right? Now, so in others, I have kept those things which had been asked earlier in AIIMS or All India exam or PGI exam, which can be very potential for the question. Yes, PAX8 for ALL. PAX8 for ALL. Yes, you can use this for ALL also. You can use it for the leukemia also because they are required for the lymphocyte development also. Yeah, molecular testing method only, right? See, many of the molecular testing method are nowadays used as a tumor marker also. These are the recent updates of the tumor markers, right? Many of the molecular genes like, snail, twist, all these are also used as a tumor marker, right? In testicular tumor, if you see, there are tumor markers which we are using like a nano G, OCT3, OCT4. These are all tumor marker for the, germ cell tumor of the testis. These are the molecular testing, right? So molecular markers are also the tumor markers. Right. Okay. So now we can see in others. I wanted to show you all these things. Oncotype DX, as I have told you, CA breast. PAX8 is for ovary and thyroid. Transcription factor 1. This is again a very important one which came in the AIIMS and All India both exam and PGI exam also. Thyroid transcription factor, as you can see, the name itself is telling, thyroid transcription factor 1 for thyroid tumor and for lung adenocarcinoma. Right. So thyroid and lung adenocarcinoma is also. Right, and ALK is not tumor marker for seminoma. ALK is anaplastic lymphoma kinase, anaplastic lymphoma kinase gene. Right, so anaplastic lymphoma kinase gene is for anaplastic large cell lymphoma and it is for neuroblastoma. Right, and they will be positive for lung tumor. So anaplastic large cell lymphoma or ALK gene is also a tumor marker for lung carcinoma, and this was the question in AIIMS 2017. This is one of the benign tumor of the lung, which is called as inflammatory myofibroblastic tumor of the lung. Inflammatory myofibroblastic tumor of the lung. Right, so myofibroblastic tumor of the lung will be also positive for anaplastic lymphoma kinase tumor marker. Right, so now I understand. So yes, adenocarcinoma of thyroid, I have not read about the thyroid, I have just known about this one, right? So now I understand. So this is the important thing about the others. I think this will be the last question for you. Tumor marker for melanoma. Marker for melanoma. Multiple answers. Now I'm waiting. Who is giving me the first answer? Who gave the first answer? Yes, no. Yes, right, very nice. So, what is the right answer? What is the tumor marker for melanoma? Yes, I want to see that. Who is giving me the right answer? A, C, A, B, S100, HMB, 45, HLA, D, B, C, D. Can't see the question. Okay, Rahul Saxena. I will tell you the options. S100, HMB, 45, MITF1, Melan A. I think, is it visible to all of you? Okay, A, B, D, A, B, D, A, B, D, MITF1. Everybody is skipping. And, this question, this will be present on the YouTube channel, right? And I think it is coming, I think. Now it is coming. Right, A, B, D. So why not MITF1? That was the JIPMER question and NEET question in 2018. MITF1 is microophthalmia transcription factor. Microophthalmia transcription factor is choroidal melanoma. Microophthalmia in aankhon mein hoga, in our eyes. A, B, C, D, all are correct answer. A, B, C, D. All are correct answer. These are all tumor marker for the melanoma. Right? These are all not ABC. All are tumor marker for the melanoma. All are tumor marker for the melanoma. So now you can see here on your screen. What are the tumor marker for melanoma? S100, HMB45, MELAN-A, and MITF1, microophthalmia transcription factor 1. So these are all tumor marker for the melanoma, right? S100 is most sensitive, right? S100 is most sensitive marker for melanoma if examiner asks you. Right, HMB45 is most specific marker for the melanoma. Most specific marker for melanoma is HMB45. Right. So ABCD, yes, the first correct answer which I got from the Mona, right? ABCD. So melan A is again tumor marker for the melanoma. MITF1, as I was telling you, this was the question which came in JIPMER also, and this came in NEET exam also. Right, so MITF1 is microophthalmia transcription factor 1. That is the full form, right? Microophthalmia, MIT is transcription factor 1. So microophthalmia transcription factor is tumor marker for the choroidal melanoma. Right? So now you understand, this is the choroidal melanoma. Or in simple word, we can say melanoma also, because this name is looking to eyes. So that is why I wanted to say choroidal melanoma, right? So these are the tumor marker for the melanoma. MITF1 is a tumor marker for the choroidal melanoma. So now you understand what are the tumor markers for the melanoma. Is it clear to all of you? Is it clear to all of you? Melanoma tumor marker is S100, HMB45, MELAN-A, and microophthalmia transcription factor 1. Right, S100 is most sensitive marker, HMB45 is most specific marker, MELAN-A is the another tumor marker, MITF1, which is called as microophthalmia transcription factor 1, they are marker for the choroidal melanoma. I think this is the last one, so I think it will be recorded. You can see also, right? Yes, vimentin can be also a tumor marker. Yes, even if you want to add, vimentin is also a tumor marker. So you can add fifth one here. Even vimentin is also a tumor marker for melanoma. You can add the fifth one.